Continuing Lazy Game Reviews Edutainment Month, we have another one of these weird little titles that I played a ton as a kid. And I mean like 6 or 7 years old, I was really a kid. And the name of the game is THM, Treasure Hunt Math. It's a shareware game that we got from a local shareware distributor called Home Learning Software from Jamestown, North Carolina. I don't know what happened to the original disc, but we did copy over several of them to this floppy here. Alright, so this is Treasure Hunt Math from 1993 by Adventure LearningWare, and you have this awesome animated EGA intro screen, and immediately the nostalgia is kicking in. For some reason as a kid, I remember this bird just disturbing me for some reason. Really, it was the shape of the wing. It just does not look right. It looks like a sword or something, not a wing. Anyways, this is the shareware evaluation copy version 1.2. There really is no difference between this and the registered version as far as software goes, but if you register it, you get all sorts of goodies from the company, like support and extra stuff. It still has my name. Anyway, this is Treasure Hunt Math's main menu, where you can put in your name, choose the subject of math, which is pretty straightforward, and the level is the difficulty of the math. You can also choose what format you would like the problems to present themselves in, either horizontal across the screen or vertical, you know, numbers on top of each other, and the activity that you would like to participate in relating to those problems. You also have the ability to turn on or off the sound, and the sound's just PC speaker beeps, but they're quite nice. There's also the secondary menu where you can choose more technical things like the date and record keeping information. There's also an editor where you can add your own problems to the game to solve. Starting the game, you're presented with a nice little map screen here of the island of completely unknown origin, as there is no story. I suppose it would be mostly irrelevant anyways, but I am still curious. Like, maybe this is sort of an island like the whole Lost scenario. Although I don't remember any hatches, Apple II Plus computers, flashbacks, or pointless side stories that I don't care about. Whatever the case is, you start right here, wherever that X means you are, and that's where you begin, as a little thing in the water. I suppose it's supposed to be a dinghy or something. It always reminded me of a bullet. Whatever the frick it is. You control it by pressing the arrow keys, and you bump into the floating buoys here and solve a problem. Once you solve the problem, you go to the next buoy and repeat until all the buoys have been collected and all the problems solved. If you get one wrong, it's no big deal. It'll tell you the right answer. But the goal, obviously, is to get them all correct. And if you do, you're presented with a bonus round. Now this is really where the appeal of Treasure Hunt Math is, because otherwise it'd be just a pretty straightforward math simulation. These bonus rounds are arcade-like sequences where you control the same whatever it was you were controlling during the math sequence, except that here you have something to avoid and something to collect. In this case, the same green buoys, which are 10 points, and the red ones, which are worth 25. And you'll also have these shark fins you'll need to avoid, otherwise your dinghy will have a seizure. Unpleasant. You'll get a bonus score added to your total, and then it's off to the next area, which is, well, I don't really know. It's kind of in between a couple of marked areas near the volcano peak, and it is on the beach. So you'll have to collect different shells, solve the problems that it presents you, and then it's off to the next bonus round. This is probably the weakest bonus round in the game. You have a crab to avoid, and you have to collect the different shells, which are worth 10 points, and there's the winking clam with a pearl in it that's worth 25. It's just the controls that are a little awkward in this one. For some reason, there's a slight delay between your first step and your second and, you know, steps after that. So it's kind of hard to get a momentum going, and the crab moves so much faster and more sporadically than you that it's pretty much impossible to avoid. The next up is somewhere sort of southeast-ish from Palm Beach, and that is where you'll be collecting falling coconuts. It's simple enough, just move left and right, and you'll catch them with whatever part of your whatever that is that you're holding touches the coconuts. Then it's on to the bonus round, where you'll be doing the exact same thing. 10 points for the single coconuts, and 25 points for the coconuts that look like balls. And of course you have the obstacle, in this case the snake, that wriggles through the trees and down to the bottom of the screen, delaying your nut grabbing. Then it's time to bypass the Crystal Lake completely and go to the Treasure Bay. This is the final area of Treasure Hunt Math, and you are a scuba diver guy, going and collecting precious items or artifacts that are somehow emanating from this ship's hull. This is a very nice looking animated screen. I really do like the aesthetics of this one. All the fish going by, you have schools of fish, bubbles, little tiny fish in the background, all the coral. It just really looks nice. It's a little bit sluggish for some reason. I guess the animation probably has something to do with that. And it doesn't matter, however fast your computer is, it's still going to run this slow. So that is kind of annoying. But then again, you're underwater, so maybe it's supposed to feel like that. Once you've collected all the items, answering all the problems correctly, it's on to the bonus round, where you will be dodging diagonal jellyfish and collecting those same items for 10 points and shiny swords for 25 points. It feels kind of sluggish, so next to the beach one, this is probably the weakest. But it's very satisfying to grab those swords for some reason, I don't know. It's one of those things that just seats itself in your mind, especially when you play this as a kid. It's like, ooh, shiny swords, must have. I can't explain it, don't ask. Once you've completed this final round, a mermaid will start swimming across the top of the screen and drop a treasure chest full of treasures for your chest, like necklaces and stuff. Your little guy will do jumping jacks while the PC speaker molests your ears for a while, and then you'll be presented with your final high score and the high score top 6 list. You know, it's funny, going through these lists, I actually did a lot better on this game as a kid. And then you get what is probably the final awesome thing of the game. You get the option to not only print your scoreboard, but also a text or graphical certificate can be printed from your printer in MS-DOS. Just select your printer type and the appropriate port, and holy crap, you will have a friggin' certificate to hang on your friggin' refrigerator. And that's it. That's Treasure Hunt Math. It's got just enough math and just enough arcadiness to make it really fun. At least, fun for doing math. Plus, it gives you the opportunity to print out your stuff and plaster all over the place. Maybe it's no number munchers, but it's still pretty friggin' awesome, and I loved it back in the day because it was something that I could get away with playing quite a lot on the computer without having to worry about wasting my time, at least as far as the parents were concerned. It's like, hey, you're still on the computer. Be like, yep, but I'm doing math. Check out this certificate. Yeah.
Matrix printers.